Good morning, children. I am V. Sara Sudha, student of St. Anne's College of Education. Today, we will learn an interesting topic related to quadrilaterals in mathematics geometry. Now, while traveling to come to school, you come across many things on the road, right? You see things like buses, houses, fields. You come across many things which have a few properties that are in common, correct? Now, in a say for example, in the classroom that you're sitting in, what are the different things that you see, children? Yes, you see a blackboard, you see a bench, you see a chair, you see a window. Now, is there any commonality in between all of these things that we have just listed down? Correct. All of them have four sides, and all of them are closed figures, correct? Now, applying the same thing to geometry and mathematics, we can define a quadrilateral to be a four-sided figure with a closed side. It is a simple closed four-sided figure. Now, what do you see here? This is a square and this is a rectangle. I'm sure all of you have learned about this in your earlier classes. Now, is there a difference between a rectangle and a square? Yes. A square has all the four sides to be equal, whereas in a rectangle, the opposite sides are equal. Do you see any commonality between a rectangle and a square? Yes. Both of them are closed figures. Both of them are four-sided figures. And also, here, you can see the properties of each figure being written. Now, in a square, opposite sides and opposite angles are equal. In both a rectangle and a square, you have angles that are at 90 degrees. Each of the angle is at a right angle or a 90 degree angle. Diagonals are equal and they bisect each other and are perpendicular to each other. Are they all to be true here? Diagonals are equal in length, they are perpendicular to each other and they bisect each other. This is about a square. Coming to a rectangle. In a rectangle, opposite sides and opposite angles are equal. Diagonals bisect each other. Are the diagonals bisecting each other? And each of the angle is at a right angle. Now, both of them, do they satisfy what we have defined for a quadrilateral? Right? A quadrilateral is a simple, closed, four-sided figure. Now, can you think of any other geometrical figures which are falling under the category of a quadrilateral? Correct. What do you see here? This is a trapezium. Now, can I call this also as a quadrilateral? Correct. I can call this also as a quadrilateral because this is also a closed, four-sided, simple figure. Now, in a trapezium, one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Now, if you consider, say for example, if I am naming my trapezium as AB, CD, then AB and CD are parallel to each other. Now, consider, say for example, this is a plane and this is one quadrilateral, or let us consider this as a quadrilateral and try to see the different parts that a plane will be divided into. Now, say for example, I have points at different parts of the quadrilateral. I'll just show you. Now see, I have three different points on this plane, correct? Now how many ways can I talk about those points? This one, this point that I am holding, let us name this as A, B and C, right? Now A lies on the exterior of this trapezium, B lies on the trapezium and C lies in the interior of the trapezium. Correct? Now, if you are asked to define what are the different areas into which my plane is divided, you can say that it will be divided into three different points. One is the exterior of the trapezium or the geometrical figure you have. Another one is on the geometrical figure. And another one is on inside or interior of the geometrical figure. Now, one more interesting thing about a quadrilateral we'll get to know today. Now, this is my plane again, right? What is this one, children? This is a convex quadrilateral. And this is a concave quadrilateral. I'll tell you what is the difference between a convex and a concave quadrilateral. Now, where are the points in this quadrilateral lying? They are in the interior of the quadrilateral, correct? Now, where are all the points that are lying in between these points lying, or the line segment which is formed in between the interior points of this quadrilateral? They are all lying in the interior of the quadrilateral, correct? Now, if you are asked to define a convex quadrilateral, then this is how you define. If all of the points that are connecting two interior points of a quadrilateral are lying in the interior of the same quadrilateral, then that quadrilateral will be called as a convex quadrilateral. Whereas, the points that are joining these two are interior points of the quadrilateral, correct? These two points are being connected with many other points forming a line segment, right? However, if you notice, these two interior points are being joined with the help of a few points lying outside or the exterior of the quadrilateral, correct? So, a concave quadrilateral is a quadrilateral in which two interior points of a quadrilateral will be connected to each other, wherein a few points will lie in the interior and a few others will lie in the exterior of the quadrilateral. Right? Now, did you understand the difference between a concave and a convex quadrilateral, children? Fine. Now, there are a few more figures you can call as quadrilaterals. Now, say for example, you must have seen the Pentagon in the US in the news sometime, right? What is the shape of a Pentagon? Correct. It has five sides. Now, can you call that as a quadrilateral? No. Why? Because you are defining a quadrilateral to be what? It is a simple, closed, four-sided figure, and a pentagon will have five sides, correct? So, a pentagon cannot be accepted as a quadrilateral. Now, coming back, you can see a few more pictures that I have with me. Sorry. What is this? This is a parallelogram. Now, what are the properties of a parallelogram? A quadrilateral with both pairs of opposite sides are parallel. That is, now say for example, this is AB, CD. Then AB and CD are parallel. AC and BD are also parallel. Opposite sides are equal. Opposite angles are equal. And the diagonals bisect each other. What is this, children? This is a rhombus. What are the properties of a rhombus? Opposite sides and opposite angles are equal. And diagonals bisect each other and are perpendicular to each other. Are they perpendicular to each other? And what does it mean by being perpendicular, children? They form a 90 degrees. Now, what is this? I'm sure all of you know about this shape. Yes, this is a kite. Now, what are the properties of a kite? A quadrilateral with exactly two pairs of equal consecutive sides. This is one pair and this is another pair. This is equal and this is equal in length. Diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Are they perpendicular? Now, diagonals are not of equal length, but they bisect one another. Now, it's obvious that you can see one diagonal is longer than the other. They, however, bisect each other and they are perpendicular to each other, but they are not of equal length. Now children, I'm sure all of you have understood what is taught today. Let's just go through one last time where you can remember all of them together. Now, if you are trying to remember quadrilaterals, firstly, how did we define a quadrilateral to be? It is a simple, closed, four-sided figure. Now, if you have to remember all the quadrilaterals together, you can remember it as a family of quadrilaterals and can start with a square and then a rectangle, a trapezium, a parallelogram, a rhombus, a kite, a convex, a quadrilateral, and a concave quadrilateral. The only difference between a concave quadrilateral and a convex quadrilateral is that two interior points of a quadrilateral will all, the points in between two interior points of a quadrilateral lying inside or interior of a quadrilateral will be called as a convex quadrilateral, and all the points connecting two interior points of a quadrilateral wherein some of them lie outside or exterior of a quadrilateral will be called as a concave quadrilateral. Yes, children, everybody has got that? Thank you.